This is so fun. So I want to share an opinion that probably won't be very popular, but I hate Las Vegas. And I know I'm supposed to love it because I'm a girl, and women, we have this Pavlovian response. Someone says Vegas, and we're like, Vegas! Like, we just automatically, like, I said Vegas here, and some woman in New Jersey was like, Vegas! Okay. What I want to share with you is that Las Vegas isn't for women. It's only for men. I will prove it to you. The number one sport in Las Vegas is what? Killing prostitutes. No, you're close. It's... lighten up. It's gambling. It's gambling. And they only want men to gamble because they incentivize men to gamble with what? Free drinks. But who bringeth the free drinks? 'Tis women. If they wanted the women to stay and gamble, they'd have the dudes from Thunder Down Under like, hey, you go, Sheila. But they don't. And I feel bad because these women are like 80 years old, exhausted, ice skater pantyhose, coming out shaking under 80 pounds of free gin and gingers. Like, I remember when this was all desert. The only thing that women are given in Las Vegas is the societal go-ahead to dress like absolute hookers and have no one judge us. Yeah, that's why we go. We land at McCarran, we throw our clothes out the window. We come out of the bathroom like it's floss and a cork. I'm empowered. And we love it. And we stay that dressed up even when we go to the pool, right? And you come down there with your pack of girlfriends. We're always in Vegas to celebrate, right? Stacy's getting married. Becky's getting a divorce. Kelly got bangs. Whatever it is. And we are dressed up. We are in primer and sunscreen and foundation. And you just spent the last hour watching some Saudi Arabian girl doing a makeup tutorial on Instagram. So we are contoured like nutcrackers. You walk outside, you set one foot outside, and you are melting. Your eyelashes are cascading down your face like caterpillars. It's hot, and we're in heels. I don't know why. Every single pool in the world has a sign above it that says, caution, wet surface. But for girls, we're like, not me, this is a good idea. I'm doing it. What happens in Vegas stays in Vegas. Yeah, like your teeth, Stacy, when you crack them on the pavement. Put on some flip-flops. And we wear dumb bathing suits. It's like, this was expensive, and it's cut out here, it's cut out here. It's like, fine, you can wear that, but I promise you this, you're gonna burn, you're gonna end up looking like a vivisection of a cow on a steakhouse menu. And I think the worst part about Las Vegas has to be the cabanas, because the types of guys that get cabanas are the worst. They're always there for Joey's bachelor party, right? They're fist pumping, they've all got fedoras, gold-plated jewelry, open shirts. They're always stunning but jacked, but they've got tiny hands, like, yeah! Yeah! Little egg beater hands, yeah! And they're trying to attract you. These men bought this cabana to project an image of wealth, but girls, these guys don't have money. These guys flew here last minute, middle seat, C group. The hot one brought his clothes in a garbage bag. His objective being to get you away from the herd, to bring you back to his junior suite that he's sharing with eight other grown men on the ground level of the hotel. These guys can't afford this cabana. They bought it together. It's not like one of them could buy the cabana. It's not like Joey had a good year pouring concrete. These guys... These men pooled their money, ladies. Pooled their money like a village buying a goat. And they want you. And even though as a woman, you know these guys are not right for you. You know that these men are hot garbage fire. Some part of you still wants them. And what I want to share with you is this. Before the age of 25, your girlfriends won't let you go with him. Before the age of 25, women have this ill-informed Taylor Swiftian notion of sisterhood. We will do anything to protect our own. Like, you can't have Stacy. We will form a phalanx around her like, no, Stacy. No, Stacy. The subtext of you can't have her is, of course, because you didn't want me, but that's a whole other TED Talk. What I want to say to the women here is enjoy the sovereignty of your youth, because after 30, it's different. After 30, guess what, chickens? You're on your own. After 30, your girlfriends don't care if you die, listen to me, shivering alone in a forest. After 30, your sex life becomes all entertainment. After 30, we're going to be like, go with him. We want to see what happens.
Thank you.